It's Grand Ole Opry time. Howdy, howdy, howdy. Speaking to you from the stage of the Ryman Auditorium in Nashville, Tennessee, where thousands have come from all parts of the country to witness the Grand Ole Opry, starring Red Foley and the Cumberland Valley Boys, with the Duke of Paducah, Minnie Pearl, the Old Hickory Singers, Grandpa Jones, Wally Fowler and his Oak Ridge Quartet, and just lots and lots of others, including our guest for tonight, Eddie Hill. Yes, it's all yours to remind you that whether you roll your own or smoke a pipe, you get more real smoking enjoyment from Prince Albert smoking tobacco. Now, our star and singing master of ceremonies, Red Foley.
Now, I was born in Dixie in a boomer shack, just a little shanty by railroad track. The humming of the drivers was my lullaby, and a freight train whistle taught me how to cry. I got the freight train blues, lordy, 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 got them in the bottom of my rambling shoes. When the whistle blows, I got to go. Whoa, lordy, I guess I'm never gonna lose the freight train blues. Let's play a little bit more. Now, my pappy was a fireman and my mammy dear was the only daughter of an engineer. My honey is a brakeman and it ain't no joke. It's a shame the way she keeps a good man broke. I got the freight train blues. Lonely, lonely. Got them in the bottom of a ranch. Oh, when the whistle blows, they got to go. Oh, lordy, I guess I'm never gonna lose the freight train blues.
Thanks a lot to you, friends. Thank you. And a great big hello to all my good friends at Davis and Prince Albert smoking tobacco's Grand Ole Opry. Golly, we've been busier in a cow's tail in fly time this week getting our show together. And for all you folks here in the Opry House and out there on the air, let me tell you, this is going to be a big night. Is that right, gang?
Yeah!
Well, let's get things going here with a good old-fashioned breakdown, something like Wake Up Susan. Here we go! Everybody, get into the party. Right foot up and left foot down. Grab your honey, go round and round. Elbow lock, calico hop, swing your gal for country block. Circle three, bird hop out, crow hop in, four hands up, gone again, and was kind of short but sweet. Yes, sir. Well, Cousin Louie Buck's been sitting back over there, not saying anything, but just listening. You got something you'd like to say, Cousin Louie?
My cousin Ed is a different man since he's taken to smoking a pipe. He's gotten real cheerful since now he enjoys that tobacco so rich and so ripe. And I've noticed the ladies all look at him twice since that pipe in his mouth makes him look extra nice. Yes, the ladies call it pipe appeal. That's the attractive, masculine look smoking a pipe gives a man. But the men call it pipe appeal when their pipes are packed with Prince Albert smoking tobacco. If you're not a Prince Albert smoker now, just try PA in your pipe and see if you don't wholeheartedly agree. For what could be more appealing in a pipe than Prince Albert's rich, full flavor combined with cool, tongue-easy mildness? That's a combination Prince Albert gives you because it's ripe, mild tobacco especially treated to ensure against tongue bite. And Prince Albert is the choice of knowing pipe smokers for another reason. It's crimp cut to pack right in a pipe and burn slow and even. Mr. Smoker, give your pipe pipe appeal with Prince Albert. See why more pipes smoke Prince Albert than any other tobacco.
So fill your pipe up with PA and take a puff or two. You'll get that extra smoking joy Prince Albert offers you.
Claude Sharp and the Old Hickory Singers have been meeting at Claude's house every night for the past week, and that means something special is coming up for them this evening. So let's listen as the boys put their heads together on that great old song called Listen to the Mockingbird.
I'm dreaming now of Hattie, sweet Hattie, sweet Hattie. I'm dreaming now of Hattie, for the thought of her is one that never dies. She's sleeping in the valley, the valley, the valley. She's sleeping in the valley, and the mockingbird is singing where she lies. Listen to the mockingbird, listen to the mockingbird. The mockingbird is singing o'er her grave. Listen to the mockingbird, listen to the mockingbird. Still singing where the weeping willows wave. Ah, will I yet remember, remember, remember? Ah, will I yet remember when we gathered in the cotton side by side? Was in the mild September, September, September. Was in the mild September, and the mockingbird was singing far and wide. Listen to the mockingbird, listen to the mockingbird. The mockingbird is singing on her grave. Listen to the mockingbird, listen to the mockingbird. Still singing where the weeping willows wave.
They say that practically everybody has had a used car. And here's the man who has the car that practically everybody has used. It's Prince Albert's Prince of Goodfellas, the Duke of Paducah.
Well, Red, you hit the jerkpot that time. I mean, jackpot. I've got a car that's so old you can't even see out the front of it. Ivy has grown all down over the windshield. That car is so old, well, right across the front it says Lincoln, vote for Lincoln. Yeah. Honest, that car ain't nothing but just a tin nightmare. It's a rhapsody in junk. The wheels ain't nothing but rubber pallbearers. I'm telling you, that car is so old and sickly, every time I spin the crank, the headlights change places. Yesterday, I was driving along in a heavy traffic jam, no cares, no worries, no fenders. You know, I was driving along and I heard my wife's drinking brother Willie. I haven't heard him in quite a while. And I heard him say, why don't you trade this bunch of junk in on a new model? I said, Willie, I can't see you. Where are you talking from? He said, I'm back here in a rumble seat. I said, why, this old car ain't got no rumble seat. He said, no wonder the seat of my pants is erasing that white line in the middle of the highway. You know, I said to my wife's brother Willie, what do you think is the worst trouble on the highway today? He said, drunken drivers. I said, you mean alcohol and gasoline don't mix? He said, oh, they mix all right, but boy, they sure leave a bad taste in my mouth. Yesterday, me and my wife looked at a new car, and the salesman pointed to the hood on that car, and he said, under that hood, there's 120 horsepower. I said, that's just the trouble with it, mister. I said, you put 120 horses in an automobile motor, you put a jackass behind the wheel, no wonder the pedestrian leads a dog's life. Sure is a lot of pedestrians here tonight. I wish you could have seen the hood on that car. Oh, that was the longest hood ever I seen. I'm telling you, that hood was so long, I had to send my wife ahead with a lantern to see the color of the traffic light. It's a fact. This new car had everything that's modern. It had the most wonderful silencer on it. A silencer, it was a gadget You ought to have seen it. It eliminated every bit of the noise. You know, it was a thing that fit right down over your wife's mouth. I thought we ought to have some husbands out there someplace tonight. You never saw so many. It had everything that was modern on there. It had buttons all over it. You know, I pushed one button and the motor started, you know, and I pushed another button and the radio started talking, and I pushed the third button and my wife started yelling. How did I know she was sitting on a hot wire with a short circuit? Have you seen the new cars? You know, some of these new cars ain't got no clutch. Of course, the girls don't mind that, as long as the fella that's driving has. But I bet a lot of you folks here tonight didn't know this. Married women drive a lot slower than married men. That's because women will go to all kinds of trouble to keep under 30. You know, my wife drives the old car we've got now. There's a lot of other things wrong with it, too. That woman drives like she was milking a cow. She drives a car like she's milking a cow. When she gets in a traffic jam, she gets so excited, she don't know whether to grab this, that, or the other. The trouble with my wife as a car driver is she's scared of her own shadow. After taking a look at what throws that shadow, I can't say that I blame her. Oh, I bet you thought I was going to say it tonight, didn't you? You know, I was reading in the paper the other day where the trouble with most women drivers are, they're too self-conscious. That ain't what's wrong with my wife as a woman driver. She's too unconscious. I got to go to the wagon, folks. These shoes are killing me.
Grandpa Jones was combing his mustache the other night, and out fell a copy of I'm Thinking Tonight of My Blue Eyes. He thought you might want to hear it, and here he is to sing it for you.
Oh, I'm thinking tonight of my blue eyes, blue sailing far over the sea. Oh, I'm thinking tonight of her own face, and I wonder if she ever thinks of me. Like the birds that go out in the spring.
I see the Duke of Paducah is sporting a new medal tonight.
That's for getting the best of the meanest dog on Lonesome Ridge.
How'd it happen, Duke?
Well, last week I was walking across a pasture minding my own business when a terrible big dog, about a 300-pounder he was, Louie, he come a-bounding at me a-growling like thunder.
You must have been scared, all right.
Nope, I just waited for that critter, and when he leapt at me, I grabbed him by the throat and lifted him from the ground and just held him there. He couldn't do a thing, and after a while he began to wag his tail kind of sheepish-like. I could see all the fight was out of him. I seen I had him, so I let him down. Of course, it wouldn't have been anything to brag about if I hadn't have done it with only one hand.
With one hand? How come?
I was using the other hand to roll a making cigarette with Prince Albert smoking tobacco.
Well, I have a little trouble believing that story somehow, except the part about rolling a making cigarette with Prince Albert. It is easy as blinking to roll your own with Prince Albert. For this very special reason, Prince Albert is crimp cut. It doesn't blow around. Instead, it clings to the paper and almost rolls itself into a smooth, firm, even burning cigarette. Of course, that's only part of the story about Prince Albert. There's rich, ripe flavor and cool mildness, too. To make a Prince Albert cigarette specially tasty and enjoyable from first puff to last, yes, for extra easy rolling, and extra good tasting, roll your own with Prince Albert, the national joy smoke.
So roll your own with good PA and take a puff or two. You'll get that extra smoke and joy. Prince Albert offers you.
Not so long ago, I sang a song down here at the Opry, just sort of warming up before we went on the air. Well, sir, it took on so well that I thought I'd include it on tonight's broadcast. It's called Many Tears Ago.
Many tears ago, you said you loved me. Oh, how happy was this heart of mine. Then a dark cloud came from out of nowhere. And the sun went down no more to shine. Many tears ago I learned too well love what it means to bear a heavy load. I found out just what is meant by sorrow. Many tears ago along the road. Many tears ago, 'twas in the springtime, when you said goodbye and went away. Oh, how well this ached heart remembers many, many tears ago today.
Thank you very much. Well, our gossip grinder Switch heard she was going to a housewarming, so she showed up with a lip match and a paid-up fire insurance policy. And here she is, Prince Albert's girl reporter, Cousin Minnie Pearl!
Howdy! I'm just so proud to be here. Well, so here it is, income tax day, 1947, and I still ain't filled out my form. I got the same figure I had income tax day 1946. Well, sir, I've been too busy to worry about that, though. This week we had a big housewarming down at Griner Switch. Uni Butterscut and his old lady moved into one of them prevaricated houses. Well, sir, Uni wasn't too happy about it because he put it together himself. And after he'd done put it together, he had the man come down and look at it. And the man said, "Mister, you put that house together upside down." And Uni said, "Well, maybe that's why my old lady keeps falling off the front porch." just like though at every housewarming, well, oh, everybody's worrying about what to take them. And sir, this didn't know most of us figured that we ought to take them something to warm up the house. Uncle Nabob said I couldn't afford no stove, but I brung over Grandpappy Simpkins. He's got a temperature of 105. That brother of mine, he was there. And long about towards the shank of the evening, well, brother decided if it is going to be a successful housewarming, he'd better warm things up quick. So playful-like, he tossed a 10-gallon can of turpentine into the new warm morning heater. We don't know if the heater was badly damaged or not. It ain't came down yet. As for brother, Mammy says she hopes he'll be down in time for spring plowing. Well, sir, we played kissing games at the housewarming. Oh, I'll tell you right now, I like to play kissing games. Well, sir... Well, I do. Well, too, though, at first I acted sort of shy and bashful, like I wanted to be coaxed. I did. Finally, I said, "I can't kiss strange men. I just can't kiss strange men." And Elvira O'Beery says, "Why, Minnie Pearl, what do you mean you can't kiss strange men?" I said, "I know, I've tried." sometimes. People that don't believe in anything in the world and lovers of the unbelievable. I can't say that word. I'm going to have to start. Oh. Well, anyway, people will be interested to know I turned down my boyfriend Hezzy for a date last Wednesday night. I did. I just told him. I said, Hezzy, I'm sorry, I can't go, but we're giving one of my girlfriends a shower tonight. He got so mad. He said, what's the idea of giving her a shower on a Wednesday night? Why can't she wait and take a bath on Saturday night, just like every feller else? But I'll see you next week.
Now, folks, I'd like to bring out a young man that's been making all of us sit up and take notice here lately. He's that singing boy from down here in Tennessee, Eddie Hill. Eddie, take... You know, Eddie, we've been wanting you on here for a long time, and Eddie happened to bring a pal of his along, a fellow named Ray Duck Atkins, to help him out as he sings a tune here that we recorded not so long ago, and thanks for you doing it on the show here.
It's
called Jolie Blonde, folks, so pour it on, boys.
And buggy and turning plow, but Donnelly rides gravy, Feely gumbo, possum up a gum sup, cups of I, cup of coffee, and Julie Bond. Well, dirty rice and picking cotton. Covers the boy, black coffee, soy poppy, potty pot. Potty Rico, well, howdy doody, Uncle John. Hundi Lego, Savekanada. I had a trio, Van Raymond on his Savage, and a Spike Guy Patty on him. Anybody else come around here? Boot and Chickie, well, good morning. And Julie Blonde.
Thanks a lot, fellas. That was mighty fine. Doggone, I'll tell you, that was good. It was a lot of fun to hear Ray and Eddie up here sort of acting up with the duck there. Now we're going to have a little serious session with ourselves and sing a hymn. If the boys will give me a little assist here, I'd like to sing an old favorite, Precious Memories, and you'll find it on page 57 of your time-worn hymn book.
Precious memories, unseen angels, sent from somewhere to my soul. How they linger ever near me, and the sacred past unfolds. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold. Father, loving mother, fly across the lonely years, and old home seems unfamiliar. childhood in fond memory appear.
Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold.
Thank you very much, friends. Somebody once explained Wally Fowler as a large body of man surrounded by Oak Ridge Quartet, and that just about describes him to a T, we'd say. Wally and his boys are going to favor us with a rockin' spiritual now, titled Gotta Live Your Religion. Tell us all about it, will you, boys?
You gotta live your religion every day.
Every day.
You gotta live your religion every day.
Every day.
On the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. You gotta live your religion every day.
Every day.
Some people go to church on Sunday, they stand up there and shout. And when they go to work on a Monday, they leave their Savior out. They think they've done their duty, and to the Lord have been true. But fine when they reach that judgment, their one day religion won't do.
You gotta leave your religion every day.
Every day.
You gotta leave your religion every day.
Every day.
On the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. You gotta leave your religion every day.
Every day.
Now take a case of Brother Daniel, who lived long, long ago. They cast him in the den of lions, the story you all know. But Daniel lived true religion, and towards Jerusalem did pray. So the Lord, Brother Daniel, delivered from the den of hungry lions that day.
You gotta leave your religion every day.
Every day.
You gotta leave your religion every day.
Every day.
On the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. You gotta leave your religion every day.
Every day.
Hey, look at that time up there, gang. It's fast and fast. I hardly knew it was dancing time. So come on, Tommy Jackson. Get that fiddle up here a little closer. We got some stepping to do. Everybody get them apart now. Swing your gals and almost kill a dancer around the Dusty Miller. Now everybody shout to the partner, so here we go. All join hands and form a ring. Search to the left with the grapevine swing. And back to the bar, just to the center and for the star. Right hand cross, how did you lift hand back and how you? Swim around that dookie boy. Dip your five and take the next chin, swing out, later swing in, four hands cross and call again. Hurry up, boys, don't be late. Take your honey and promenade it. Looks like that's about all the time we got that coming. Yes, sir. Well, see, I wasn't just kidding about that clock playing us such mean tricks, because now I see it's time to hunt for Cindy and head along for home, boys.
Get along home, Cindy. Get along home, I say. Get along home, Cindy. One more night and day.
Cindy in the summertime, Cindy in the fall. Can't have Cindy all the time, won't have Cindy at all.
Get along home, Cindy. Get along home, I say. Get along home, Cindy. One more night and day.
Well, this has been one of the most enjoyable Saturday nights we've ever spent here at the Prince Albert Opera House Neighbors, and we hope to repeat it mighty soon. Next Saturday night, as a matter of fact, when we'll call for you in the buckboard. There'll be the Duke of Paducah, Minnie Pearl, the Old Hickory Singers, Wally Fowler, Oak Ridge Quartet, Grandpa Jones, and a very special guest. Yes, sir, and I'll be there, too, with all my Cumberland Valley gang. And remember, if you can't come right, won't you? Till a week from tonight, then, this is Red Foley saying, see you Saturday night at Prince Albert's Grand Ole Opry!
Prince Albert Smoking Tobacco's Grand Ole Opry came to you from Nashville, Tennessee. This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.